Somebody who's happy to front the cameras is the National Senator Barnaby Joyce. He's indicated, as Chris Yeoman just said, that he's available to fill the pre-selection vacancy created by Richard Torbay's sudden withdrawal. If he beats the sitting member, Tony Windsor, Senator Joyce will then be in pole position to contest the leadership of the Nationals if he wishes. That could see him become Deputy Prime Minister in an Abbott coalition government. Barnaby Joyce joins me from our Canberra studio. Senator Joyce, is the National Party going to endorse you as its candidate for New England?
That is a whole heap of hypotheticals there, Leigh. I was just waiting for when I was going to become the Pope and the King and an astronaut. Look, let's truncate it down. We have a role to do as part of the opposition. That's to win government, to try and remove the chaos that you've seen on your show tonight. To do that, we have to win seats off the Green Labor Party Independent Alliance. The seat of New England, which is next door to where I live, is part of that Green Labor Party Independent Alliance. The people of New England still feel overwhelmingly let down that that Tony wasn't straight with them at the start. He didn't say before the election, look, I might back the Labor Party and the Greens. And so they felt the same manner that Australia felt when Ms Gillard said that there'll be no carbon tax under a government she leads. Now, Mr Windsor also said one of the mechanisms of him supporting the Green Labor Party Independent Alliance was that it brought a sense of stability. Well, I don't know what you call that you just had in your show there. That looked awfully like instability. That looked instability par excellence.
Right. Let's leave Labor to talk about themselves. You bring up Tony Windsor. He's said that Barnaby's on record as saying that New England is his second choice. He's actually the second choice to Mr Torbay. I don't think it's about New England for Barnaby. It's very much about him and positioning himself, his view of himself in terms of being a great leader of the Nationals. What do you say to that?
Well, you know, a ringing endorsement from Mr Windsor. What else would you expect? I mean, good luck to Mr Windsor. I know that he's he's a little bit bitter and he's a little bit angry, and that's fair enough. I can understand why this government has been a fiasco. But what I can say is that we're talking about the seat next door to me, not on the other side of the planet. We're talking about the area where I was born, where my wife was born, where my four kids were born, where my mother lives, where my father lives, where my wife's mother lives, where my wife's father lives, where I went to primary school, where I went to university, where I played football for New England, the under-21s, and Central North. I don't quite know what else Mr Windsor wants me to do, wrap myself in the New England flag. What else does he have in mind, except from the fact that he's trying to cover up that his government, the government that he sponsors every day, is a fiasco, a rolling fiasco.
I'll talk about some of your personal goals in a second, but firstly, the National Party, through Richard Torbay, is now smeared by association with the Eddie Obeid corruption scandal. That must be a very unwelcome gift.
Look, what you can tell from this is the moment we found out about this, it was dealt with immediately, and Mr Torbay, and I had no idea what this was about, but Mr Torbay has been asked to step down, he's resigned, and that's it. Now, what I do know, and this is how absurd is this, to the best of my knowledge, Mr Obeid and Mr McDonald, Mr Ian McDonald, are still members of the Labor Party.
But
how ridiculous is that?
Does it blunt, though, your attacks on Labor over this when you have a person formally endorsed by the National Party, also now under investigation by ICAC?
Well, the thing is how we dealt with it, how we dealt with this issue immediately. Mr Obeid is still a member of the Australian Labor Party, the party that is supported by Mr Tony Windsor and the Australian Greens. Mr McDonald is still a member of the Australian Labor Party. We've had reports that they're considering, due to peculiar circumstances or extenuating circumstances, that they might get rid of them from the Labor Party. What else do they need? What else are they looking for? A nuclear holocaust? What possibly more could go wrong that would deserve them to be expelled?
Let's go back to your personal ambition. If you move to the House of Representatives, should the Nationals leader, Warren Truss, watch his back?
No, not at all. I'll say it categorically, over and over and over again. I have no intention whatsoever of challenging Warren Truss. No intention whatsoever.
So why do you want to move to the lower house then?
Because we have to win this election. And these circumstances were not of my making. We have to make sure that we give the people of New England the best chance of having fair representation in the coming government, chance of a fair fight.
You've said in the past, though, that you'd be open to the idea of the Nationals leadership if it presented itself. Is that still your position?
Yeah, but that's after Warren retires. It's not before he retires.
Do you think that you've got the experience, judgment and knowledge to be the Deputy Prime Minister or the Acting Prime Minister if required?
I don't have to worry about that because that's not the job application I'm applying for. I'm applying for pre-selection. I will turn up to the pre-selection for New England. That's the only job I have to worry about. The rest is, you might as well ask me, do I have, am I considering doing any other jobs? As I said, Pope, King, whatever you like, but I'm not. I'm going for pre-selection for New England. And I thank people for their endorsement of taking the next 50 steps, but I'm just not quite there yet.
But you've kept open the idea that at some point when Warren Truss retires, you would be interested in the leadership. I'm just asking you, do you think that you've got the qualifications and the experience for some of those really high-level jobs that you would take if an Abbott government is elected?
Well, Leigh, I've been a shadow minister now for a number of years. I think I've run my own business. I don't know, you mightn't like the way I use my peculiar version of the English language, but it is my mechanism of communicating, which a vast number of Australians relate to. Now, what I can say is, at some time, way, way in the future, I welcome another interview with you about that, but that is just not on the cards. Warren Truss is the safest set of hands in Canberra. He will be the Deputy Prime Minister, and he will be a great asset to our nation because we are looking for the adult in the room. We are looking for stability, and Warren Truss provides that, and long may that be the case.
You have such a higher profile, even now, though, than Warren Truss. Don't you think a lot of people in the National Party would like to see you as leader?
It's just not an option. I mean, we both have completely different styles, but I admire Warren because I've worked with Warren. I see what he does around the leadership table, which I'm part of, and I see what he does around the cabinet table, the shadow cabinet table, which I'm part of. I see what he does around the National Party table. He is a person who reads his file. He knows his detail. We need him because we need a details man to deal with the peculiar ideas man, which Stephen Conroy is, and the absolute pandemonium of a fiasco of a treasurer, which Wayne Swan is, and the day-by-day proposition of who the next Prime Minister is, which could be a whole range of people tonight, whether it's Crean, Ferguson, whether it's... Well, could be Gillard, but I doubt it. Whether it's Kevin Rudd, who would know? I mean, I'd look for an ad in the paper, wanted, one Prime Minister of Australia.
Barnaby Joyce, thanks so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you very much.